to another episode of J3D.
This is Jimmy and Yada, and today instead of bringing you a parable or a drama, we're just gonna talk to you.
We're gonna get real, because this is a subject that you need to know. We're gonna talk about the plan of salvation. Now, the question is, what do you understand, what do you think it takes to get to heaven? Do you know what it takes to get to heaven?
Definitely salvation.
Well, yeah, that's why we're plan of salvation.
Yeah. Are you saying there's more to that?
Yes. So the Bible states it's called faith. Now, that's a simple word.
F-A-I-T-H.
However, we're going to focus on what each one of those
stands for.
Each one of those letters stands for. Mm-hmm. So F is for forgiveness.
Forgiveness.
Because we cannot have eternal life and heaven without God's forgiveness. This is represented in the Bible.
It's on Ephesians 1:7, and it says, "He is so rich in kindness and grace that he purchased our freedom with the blood of his son and forgave our sins."
I know we talk about this a lot. This is a scripture from the Bible that's used quite often, but it's true. We are saved through the blood of Christ, and we wouldn't be where we are at now if it wasn't for the sacrifice that Jesus made for us.
Amen.
Now, A is for available. Forgiveness is available.
To you and to us.
Exactly. It's available for all. That's represented in John 3:16.
And I'm sure everybody knows this verse, but the only reason why I'm reading it is because I know it in Spanish and not English. But for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Now that's a powerful word, because he's basically spelling it out that without God's love, none of us would be here. He could have wiped us away with Noah's flood long time ago.
Or with the dinosaurs.
Exactly.
You know?
And
if we were around.
But I need you to understand that it's not automatic. God's love is earned. This is represented in Matthew 7:21.
This verse says, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who does the will of my Father who is in heaven."
Basically, as long as we stick to what the Bible says, the scripture, and the way of acting as a true Christian, will you be accepted into heaven, into his kingdom.
And also, even though, you know, forgiveness is available, it's also available for you to give to others. You know, if God was able to show that forgiveness to you, then it should be easy for us to show that forgiveness to others. Also, with available, what I perceive is that God is looking for an available heart. So, you know, God, and we've mentioned this a lot, but God can use you in many ways if you're willing to open up your heart, open up your mind for it. But the reason why he looks for somebody available is because God's looking for disciples, God's looking for leaders, and that could be you, kind of like we've became leaders. You know, it was because we were available even before we got the position. We were already trying to help out the youth, you know, trying to be there for them, going into trips with them, you know, stuff like that, because we wanted to show God that we were available for the plans that he had for this specific group.
And the plans that we didn't even know we had for ourselves.
This is true.
And if you remember, probably about 4 or 5 videos ago, forgiveness is supposed to be 70 times 7 a day. So that's 490 times a day you're supposed to give forgiveness.
This is true. So what's T for?
No. I.
Oh, we're an I.
Yes.
F-A-I. Okay.
I misspelled it. No, you misspelled it. I is for impossible. We all know what God does is impossible. Because he is the master of the impossible.
Yes.
It is impossible for God to allow sin into heaven, though. Because of who he is, God is living and just. His judgment is against sin.
That's right. And you can find that on James 2:13. "There will be no mercy for those who have not shown mercy to others. But if you have been merciful, God will be merciful when he judges you." on your judgment day.
Basically, as long as you have shown kindness to others, God will show kindness onto you. We sometimes are too quick to judge others, especially youth. You know, that middle school lifestyle,
even high school too.
Somebody says something about you or says something about somebody else, and next thing you know, you got beef.
Or even worse, the cliques. If you're in the jocks or if you're into, you know, jocks are sometimes, no offense.
I was a nerdy jock. Thank you very much.
Jocks are sometimes, you know, the bullies or the ones that actually judge others for not either being good at sports or for being too nerdy. You know, even the cheerleaders or whatever it is that you're, the group that you're in high school or even in middle school, you know, you tend to judge others because they don't do the same things that you do yourself.
That's true. Now, how many of y'all know that we are all sinners? Just by nature. I mean,
every day. You know you sin today.
just by nature, we are sinners, and we have to understand that, and it needs to be represented and accounted for, because that's a part that you have to acknowledge and be humble that you are a sinner. Otherwise, how are you supposed to ask for forgiveness?
And humble heart. It even says it in the Bible. If you're gonna pray, you better make sure that you're doing it with a humble heart, because even though the Lord may be hearing you, that doesn't mean he's actually listening, you know? To you, if you're coming to him with like a raw heart or with your own agenda, you know.
But because of who we are sinners. This can be found in Romans 3:23.
Romans 10:9.
No,
3:23. Oh.
For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Now, the big question is, how could a sinful person enter heaven when God doesn't allow sin? Well, that comes with T, which is for turn, which means to repent, actually.
Okay.
To turn away from sin. And the only way we can turn away from sin
is by turning away from our sin in ourselves.
Exactly.
Right?
And the truth from the turn for something, sin and self, can be found in Luke 13:3.
And this says, I tell you no. But unless you repent, you too will all perish.
And when he means by repent, it means to acknowledge all of the sins, all of the bad things that you have done, you've thought, and give them on to God so that he may bestow mercy onto you and forgiveness.
Nice.
I was like a little shined down, honey.
Just a little, a drizzle.
And also, to turn to someone, trust Christ only. Basically, what I'm trying to say there is turn away from those bad influences and turn straight to Christ, because he's our only Lord and Savior. He's the only one that bled for us to be washed of sin.
Even when you feel like your whole world is crumbled already, the only one that can fix it is God. You know, sometimes it's really easy for us to just be like, oh, well, you know, God probably has other things to take care of. He's probably not going to care for my life or what I have going on. But no, God is always there for you. And he's showing you every time he keeps giving you another chance and another chance and another chance. You know, God is always there for you.
And a good verse for that is Romans 10:9.
And this says, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved.
And we all will be saved. Now, the big H, it's not just for Henshaws, which is us. That's our last name. But it is also H is for heaven. Heaven is the eternal life. Here, and which here can be represented in John 10:10.
The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I have come that they may have life and have it to the fullest.
And what Jesus was saying there was he has come down to bring life to us and to let us have it in full, to be able to live the life that you live now. Something we all kind of take for granted, to be honest with you. We kind of wake up every morning and we're like, oh, let me go brush my teeth, let me comb my hair, let me get ready, or text the whole time. Some of y'all use
catch up with Instagram as soon as you wake up, or TikTok.
But in all actuality, that was given to you, and every day is precious to you. And also, heaven is also given us to us hereafter.
So it's saying, when it says here and hereafter, it's saying so that you can enjoy your life here on earth to the fullest, but also your life after here that you're on earth. You know, once you're in heaven, obviously you're gonna
gates.
Yeah, you're gonna be used up there.
For sure. And that one's represented in John 14:3.
And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, so that you may also be where I am.
That's a powerful word. Now, how can a person have God's forgiveness, heaven and eternal life, and Jesus as a personal Savior and Lord? Do y'all know? Do you know?
I mean, if I read your papers, I know.
Well, it's by trusting in Christ. That's what we've been saying this whole time. And asking Him for forgiveness. Because He's the only one that can bestow it on all of us. Take the steps of faith described by another meaning of faith. I actually didn't know this one. I don't think you knew this one.
What?
The other meaning of faith.
What is the other meaning of faith?
Forsake all, I trust Him. Forsaking all, I trust Him. That doesn't mean forsake everyone. Everyone, leave me alone. It's just me and Christ.
Yeah, yeah.
No,
just
it means
no social.
It means the worldly world is there, but your spiritual world is what you need to focus on. You need to have those moments with Christ in a dark room. I've known some people that go to a closet to pray. So you just need that time and to focus with Him, ask Him forgiveness, not social media, not Facebook, not Instagram.
Because Lord knows nowadays everybody's looking for the acceptance online, right? The acceptance in social media. And I mean, you know, we are here making these videos, but our purpose is so you do have a life of salvation. You know, like right now we're breaking down the plan of salvation for you, because even though your age ranges from what, 11 to 17 years old, we know that even though your parents have been taking you to church each and every single day, there's a lot of you that haven't really accepted God into your heart and into your life personally. You know, because you can also just accept because your parents are here, because your parents have told you God is good, so you gotta believe that God is good. Like, no, this is a very personal salvation, because just because your parents know God or your family knows God doesn't mean that you're gonna know God as well, you know?
Exactly.
They've been able to meet Him through His years, you know, get a connection with Him and everything, and that's why you've seen your parents live the life that they live now. But you, this is about you now, and this is what we really care for. You know, that you're saved.
Now, I understand. In this modern society that we live in, y'all feel like y'all are a little bit more mature, and y'all can be. Y'all see a lot more things than
say
our brother Mike behind the camera ever saw. However, that just makes it even more crucial that you have salvation, because you've already seen things you're not supposed to see.
You're being exposed, and you probably don't even know it, because the world makes things like, and I'm sorry I'm bringing it up, but like lesbianism, or like, you know, a whole bunch of things that are going on in the world. All
acceptable.
These abortions. Yeah, like normal. Like you're supposed to wake up and be like, oh yeah, the world around me is doing it, so it's whatever. That's not how we should think.
And it's not. We have our set ways, and this is our way, this is our plan to salvation, so that we may spend it with the great Father above, the Holy Father. Now, what I need y'all to do is, after y'all have learned this, y'all have taken this and put it as a part of your life, go and influence others, because that's the only way that you are going to save somebody else, is if you tell them about it.
Speak it through your mouth.
And build the army of God. because we are all warriors for the purpose of God, to preach, to learn, to speak about Jesus Christ. That's why we're here speaking to y'all.
You're probably wondering, why is this girl wearing a mask? Well,
she couldn't help it.
Because we were unmasking the plan of salvation to you, you know? It kind of coordinates. If it doesn't, well, it's a good giggle too.
It gave all of us giggles. And you remember, you can catch us on any social media platform.
Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook. Actually, we don't have Snapchat, but Facebook.
At BCP Church Houston.
And YouTube. Don't forget, we're on YouTube as well.
All the time, streaming.
And also, Sundays, we have English and Spanish services. The English is at
9
a.m. The Spanish is at 11:15 a.m. So if you do want to tune in, you sure can. We're always there. We're never a minute late. You know, sometimes it might be a little glitchy, but we're there.
So like and subscribe, and we'll catch you next week.
Have a great week.